y'all good evening, how's everybody doing?
Good.
Good. Apologize that I couldn't take the food tonight, but I don't eat barbecue at night. Some of you that might realize why, I don't know. I found out a long time ago that it didn't agree with me. I love my sleep better than anything, so I don't want to be jumping up. I don't speak as loud as he does, but I agree with you on a lot of things, Mr. Ford. One thing that I wanted to mention, though, you mentioned the transportation bill. You know, when that bill first came out, all of the money luckily was taken away from us. I mean, honestly, we looked at that bill and said, my gosh, what are they trying to do? So we went to work, and we made sure that our sales tax and things like that for education and things like that were not lost, because we stood to lose $12 million a year between the schools, the city, and the county. So we got that put back in there. So, but there's a few things that are good, but there's a few things that are bad. I agree with you on that. And hopefully Dexter, y'all will take care of some of those things and start thinking about us locally. We still haven't seen what the formula is, but the money that the state takes in, how we're going to get some of that back. So that's a big thing. It is. When I ran for mayor 4 years ago, there was a few things that, you know, I've never been a politician. I consider myself a public servant. I didn't run as a politician. I made a statement one day that I was needing something to do. I was retired. I sold my business the second time, and I asked some people if I could just help collect money, run errands, go to the post office at no charge. And the next thing I knew, I had a bunch of people ask me to run for mayor. And I said, y'all are crazy. I don't have an agenda. You know, I'm not mad at anybody. I'm not the one up there to try to turn the world upside down or anything. But they talk in the running, and when I do something, I do it full blast, and luckily I was elected, fortunately I was elected. But I ran on a few things, and I just want to go over those and tell you where I think we stand with those. The first one was the city and county were at odds, have been at odds with one another. And we've got to work together with dual governments like we have in this county, there's no question about it. And we have made great strides. The chairman of the county commissioner and I talk, even have lunch every couple of weeks to talk about the things that we see that are affecting the citizens of Lowndes County. Because I believe, as a resident of Valdosta, I'm also a resident of Lowndes County. Sometimes I wish others thought that way. But anyway, we've made some great strides. One of the other things was I ran on spending taxpayer dollars wisely. When I took office in 2012, we had a budget of $86 million with a budgeted deficit of $8 million. This year we're budgeting $85 million with a $6 million excess. So we've come a long way from 3 years ago. One of the other things was establishing better relations with our state legislators and our delegation. We had run aground in Atlanta, quite honestly, and we weren't getting recognized like we should. Whatever reason, I've got my own reasons, but I'm not going to get into those. And I also offered to provide the leadership that Valdosta needed at that time. And I feel like I've done that. I've represented all of Valdosta, not just the north end or the west end or the east end or the south end. I've represented all of Valdosta. And I don't think any of you can argue with that. Some of the accomplishments that we've made since I became mayor, we were ranked 51st out of 179 cities included in the 2013 best performing cities. The only other city in Georgia that ranked ahead of us was Gainesville, Georgia, where the governor's from. I'm not sure that all the counting is correct, but the Department of Community Affairs designated Valdosta Main Street program as a gem, which means Georgia's exceptional Main Street. Our water treatment plant received Plant of the Year by the Georgia Association of Water Professionals. We completed a $40 million renovation of our Mud Creek wastewater treatment plant. We're 6 months ahead of schedule on our $35 million force main project and 12 months ahead of schedule on our Whippa-Coochee wastewater treatment plant, which is a total of $56 million. And part of that, we're paying cash for as we progress, but as sales tax comes in, when we complete our Whippa-Coochee wastewater treatment plant, will be paid for by cash. There will be no loans on that. We've completed the first of four gateway projects. I don't know whether you know a lot about me or not, but at one time, and several times in my life, I've ridden a motorcycle. And so one Saturday morning, I got on my motorcycle, and I entered every entrance way into Valdosta, and I did not see the first welcome sign. There was none. There was one out here on Lake Moore that had been there so long that the vines had grown over and you couldn't see it. So one of my pet projects the last couple of years has been to put welcome signs coming into Valdosta. We did the first one on North Valdosta Road. We're in the process of doing one on Madison Highway right now, which people from the airport will see as they come into town. And got a lot of confidence on that. We have completed reviews, and this was another one of my projects, of our ethics, noise, landscape, alcohol, and stormwater ordinances. And we're fixing to embark upon another one. Tim hadn't heard about it yet, but I've been looking at that, and that has to do with the way people around Valdosta keep their property. And quite honestly, I get embarrassed sometimes by the fact that our lawn maintenance people blow all the leaves and the pines grow out in the street. You're not fixing to stop me, are
you?
30 seconds. We requested and received a meeting with the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers to discuss the regional flooding issues. As a result, the city, U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, and the Army Corps of Engineers, we received quite a bit of benefits from them, and they're doing quite a few studies. Valdosta was named Smart Energy City of the Year. Mr. Quarterman would like that. What do I want to accomplish in my next term? I want to continue to review and revise our ordinances. Have in place a truck bypass. We've gotten stopped the downtown truck traffic, and we're fighting an uphill battle with that quite hard. Possible have some form of city-county transit plan. Yes, I'm a forward-thinking person. I look to the future, and yes, Valdosta is going to have some sort of transportation plan. But I'll tell you this, I'm not in favor of straddling the city and the county, and it has to be a joint city-county project. I'm not in favor of straddling the city with $1.5 million subsidy every year that we've got to come up with. And that's what it looks like right now. Next year is going to be one of the most important years, and I'll finish with this. Next year, 2016, we negotiate the service delivery strategies with the county. Now, that's going to be a fight like it was 10 years ago, I assure you. But I'm in favor of consolidating as many services as we can between the city and the county to cut down on the cost of taxpayers. And we have a low millage rate, we have low water and sewer rates, and I don't want to see those things go up. I want to see them maintained. So if I'm elected mayor, I'll continue to lead like I have the last 4 years and give you 100% of my time. I don't have anything else to do. So thank you very much.